Hi, welcome to my channel. I shoot a film and I develop it by myself, especially the black-white film. That's very easy to do, develop at home. I usually develop the 8 or 10 film roll each time. So I always want some develop, let me use it freely. For example, if I only need 1,000 millimeters, I just mix it 1,000 from the powder chemicals, mix it fresh each time and use it, discard it. But almost all the powdery developer, they all need prepare a large amount at one time. For example, like the Kodak Extra, it must prepare 5 liters in one time. If it be 1:1 diluted, it almost can process 40 film roll, which is almost impossible to use up. And then you will get the experience, which is using the expired chemicals. Although the liquid developer can be prepared as much as you need, but the stock solution, they also have the shelf time problem. And usually the liquid developer is more expensive than the powder state. So is there a kind of develop that can be prepared by self according to the needs of each developing volume without considering the shelf life? Also, it must be very simple and low price. The answer is yes, the Kodak D-23 formula. Now the many kind of developer formulation are public available. Like the most common, the D76, and also for the Kodak XX, the motion picture film, the develop D96, they all can be made by self from the chemical powders. Even for the color negative motion picture film, the ECN2. However, most of them require mixture of multiple chemical agents. And I almost give up as soon as I see the formulas that too complicated. But the Kodak, the D23, it only need 2 kind of chemicals. Is it very simple? Especially for people like me, I was used to fall asleep in middle school chemistry classes. There are no difficulty. You can mix fresh developer each time from the powder as you need and discard it when used up, which is very simple and convenient. And usually, I think the simplest way is the best. So in this video, I will sharing with you how to make the most simplest developer, the D23, and also the feature of the film that developed by D23. The formula of D23 is for 1,000 milliliters developer, metal 7.5 gram, sodium sulfide 100 gram. Add water to 1,000 milliliters. I bought these 2 chemicals from Yodobashi Camera, metal 25 gram and sodium sulfide 500 gram, about $15. That can make 3,000 D23 stock develop, which is very cheap. Maybe buy more in other chemical store, the cost more lower, I think. I need 2,000 milliliters developer, so I wait out the 15 grams metal and 200 grams sodium sulfide. The metal is easily soluble in water, but not easily soluble in sodium sulfide solution. This means to dissolve the metal first. However, metal is oxidized very fast after encountering water, which will make the developing solution become yellowish. So before adding metals, take a little sodium sulfide, put in the water first. Can be as little as half teaspoon, or it can be 4 to 5 grams. This prevents metal from oxidizing and color changing as soon as it dissolved in water. And the result, the developed solution is pure and transparent. I always put the develop, the fixer, and the stopper into the heated water bath. Let the temperature rise to 20 degrees in the cold weather. I use stock dilution. For the Ilford Delta 400, develop time is 7 minutes. And the Ilford HP5 is need 7.5 minutes. These data can be obtained from the digitaltruth.com website. Like other developer, the standard processing is no different. The D-23 is not sensitive to temperature, so even if the difference is 1 or 2 degrees, it has no effect. Moreover, D-23 is not very strict on the development time control. Even if the development time is extended, the detail of the bright part will not be lost, but the detail of the dark parts will increase. The D-23 formula was released by Kodak in 1954, but Ansel Adams already used it in 1944. He has mentioned that in his book, The Negative. Obviously, the D-23 developer has been used by photographer more earlier. The D-23 can make the developed film present a very beautiful low contrast. Very soft image feel with excellent tonal separation. Especially shoot in the sunny days, it can perfectly retain the detail of the bright and dark part. D-23 only needed 2 kinds of chemicals. It's very simple and highly effective. As Ansel Adams said in his book, the D-23 is a fine-grained developer with excellent tonal separations. D-23 can be diluted 1-to-1, making it more cheaper. So I have a question. Why it's such a perfect developer formula rarely mentioned now? After I thinking about it, and I get the answer is, since the 1970s, the people mainly used 35mm film and camera, the more smaller format. The low contrast image is not liked by 35mm user. For the 35mm film, the people want more detail and sharpness that are not easy to get on the 35mm film. So the manufacturer developed many kind of the micro grain developer like Ilford DDX. But for the medium film and the large format film, they don't need to worry about this at all. So you can even find the 35mm camera lenses, they usually have more contrast than the medium format camera lenses. And even the 35mm film is more a little bit of contrast than the medium format and the large format film. I remember I saw a photo show in Tokyo 8 years ago. It was an 8x10 large format film shot by Ansel Adams, the contact printer, which can get a clear understanding how is his film original negative. It was a very excellent experience that shocked me. Even now, I still think that is the most perfect black-white image in this world, no matter film or digital. I think the D23 is perfect for the medium format and large format film processing. But for the 35mm, it's also good, but not 100% like it. But it is still worth to try. The D23 is the perfect developer for photographer who love the traditional beauty that we almost forgotten. Okay, thanks for watching. See you.